Welcome back. Today we're going to be doing a math manipulative that you can use at home if your student is struggling, or you can use it in the classroom as a center rotation just to give them some extra practice. Okay, so really all that you're going to need for this specific center is a permanent marker and some cups. It really doesn't matter what kind of cups, depending on your age group. You would determine whether it needs to be super sturdy or not so sturdy, depending on how fragile they are. Okay, so this is a really super simple center activity. Like I said, you can do it at home if you feel like your student is struggling. You can use this for addition, multiplication, subtraction, division, whatever you feel like your child needs to work on. It's kind of like getting those math facts. So it's just another way, instead of those flashcards, to have them do it with cups. Okay, so the first thing that you're going to do is you're going to need several cups, but the first thing that I would do is I would take one of your cups, has nothing on it, okay, and I don't know how well you're going to be able to see this, but we'll try my best. And in about three different spots around the rim of the cup, in the big spot, you are going to put the equal sign, okay, in about three spots, okay? Then on another cup, about evenly spread out, so four places that you can map with your own eye, it doesn't have to be perfect, you're going to put division, subtraction, addition, and multiplication symbol, okay, around the cup. Those two cups are final. Now, to start, you only need about four number cups, okay? So then you're going to take four more cups, and again, on the rim of the cup in the wide spot, you are going to space out the best that you can, number one through nine, all the way around. So I don't know if you can see, but it goes all the way around my cup, okay? So you're going to have about four of those, okay? So whenever we start putting our cups together, I have my number cup, I have my symbols, which is multiplication, subtraction, division, addition, another numbers cup, my equal cup, and then I like to put on two number cups because when you start that multiplication, sometimes your numbers are a little higher. So go ahead and throw that extra numbers cup onto the end. Okay, so now if you look really close, you can see that you can create number problems with these cups. Okay, super easy to create, super easy to fix if they get broken, super easy to change to four different kinds of math problem. Okay, so if I wanted to do 4 times 5, okay, then I would have my equals, then I would have to figure out what is 4 times 5, okay? So I would go and find 2 and 0, okay? I have 20. There's your answer, okay? And I told you all not to put, I said 1 through 9, go ahead and throw that 0 on there, total mishap, okay? So you wanna go ahead and throw that on there as well. So let's see that you did 9 divided by 3 gives you what? Okay, then you're gonna have to figure out what is. That's when you can throw that cup off and find your answer there. Okay, you don't always have to have this cap. There's also a place on there for a blank spot if you just want to put a blank spot at the end and not have to take it on and off. But this is for simple numbers. Now, as you get into bigger numbers, go ahead and throw that number cup back on. Go ahead and make some more number cups for the first number. Go ahead and take it off and throw a number cup in here. Okay, you can make this as easy or as complex as your student allows. So do it for the individual student. Okay, when I've used these in centers before, in third grade, I would sometimes specialize per student. So I might have this student take, you know, an extra cup off, but I might have this student throw an extra one on. So those students that are struggling are getting that basis practice, but those students that are advanced are still getting the challenge that they need to push them forward as well. Okay, like I said, super easy. Cups and a pen, or a permanent marker, super easy. You can do this at home. You can do this in the classroom, okay? If they're struggling, math is something that never changes and that they're going to use their entire life, especially addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division, okay? So make sure that these four, if nothing else, is something that they really, really know, just like the back of their hand. Okay, I hope that was helpful. I hope to see you guys soon. If you found this helpful, go ahead and hit that like button down below. And please make sure to subscribe to our channel. If there's something that you would like to see, let me know and I'll see what I can do. Bye guys.